Hi, I'm John Lampe. I'm a licensed pesticide applicator in the categories of natural areas and forests. Today I'm going to do a video on what herbicides will kill a tree. This is a really important question that homeowners and non-professionals are increasingly confronting with all the non-native trees they're finding on their properties these days. Now, if you do it right, getting rid of an invasive tree can be very easy. If you do it the wrong way, it can be very frustrating. In this video, I'm going to discuss with you how to do it the right way. So I'm going to step inside and continue with the video. Incidentally, winter is a great time to kill an unwanted tree. So on a day like today, maybe with a little less snow, you can actually get out and do a lot of these things that I described in this video. There are two herbicides that are widely available for homeowner use that work on trees. These are glyphosate and triclopyr. With glyphosate, make sure you have a concentrate, i.e. a bottle having over 20% active ingredient. Check the label. You'll see a listing of the active and inert ingredients on the label. With triclopyr, make sure you have a concentrate that's a bottle having over 8% active ingredient. Again, check the label. I work for a company called Green Shoots. We sell a package that has everything you need to make a precision application of herbicide. However, even if you don't use our products, the directions we give you in this video will be helpful to you. The package sold by Green Shoots contains a concentrated glyphosate herbicide. It also has a marker dye that shows which stems you've treated. And finally, foam herbicide works great for killing trees because the herbicide stays wet longer, so the herbicide can be absorbed into the tree's vascular system. Before you start your project, do some research. Identify the species of the targeted tree. Check to make sure the herbicide you picked works on that targeted species. And then check with reputable sources such as university extension documents. They are available online. We also offer a number of species-specific videos that are very helpful. Which herbicide do I prefer? Generally, I like glyphosate. It works on most tree species. It binds tightly to soils. This helps protect nearby desirable plants. Finally, it breaks down relatively quickly, which is good for the environment. Now let me describe a simple procedure that you can use to kill a small tree. The tools you'll need are pretty straightforward. For larger trees, use a handsaw. For trees up to about 1.5 inches in diameter, use a pair of loppers. And then for small trees, if you want, you can just use hand pruners. When you cut the tree down, leave a stump that is about 1 to 4 inches high. I generally like to cut lower to the ground if possible. Apply the herbicide immediately after cutting, that is within about 2 to 5 minutes. If the stump face has not been treated within a half hour, recut the stump and apply the herbicide. You want to make sure that you apply the herbicide to the outside of the cut stump, i.e. to the live inner bark of the tree. This is absolutely critical. This is the only part of the tree that will transport the herbicide down to the roots. Here's a photo of herbicide being applied to a cut stump of common buckthorn. Notice how there's no herbicide being applied to the central part of the stump face. Apply the herbicide to the entire circumference of the tree. To ensure that you kill the roots, don't disturb the stump for about 6 weeks or so. Now let's go over some of the common mistakes that people make when trying to kill a tree. Probably the most common mistake people make is doing the job
at the wrong time of year. The worst time of year is probably the season most often picked by people, springtime. Early summer is also not a good time for an application. Fall and winter are the best times. Why is this so important? Remember that the objective of your application is to introduce the herbicide into the live inner bark or phloem. In springtime, phloem sap is rising. This feeds leaf growth of the tree canopy. In fall and winter, phloem sap is falling to store energy and nutrients in the roots. You want the herbicide to travel with the phloem sap into the roots. That's why fall and winter are the best times. The second mistake people make is using bad application technique. For example, they may flood the stump face with herbicide. You can understand why this mistake is made because the herbicide label suggests this for many products. However, if you do this, you will waste a tremendous amount of herbicide and potentially endanger non-target plants. If an herbicide is well placed on the stump face, it only takes a little to kill the tree. For example, about 1 milliliter or about 0.03 ounces of herbicide solution with 20% active ingredient will kill a tree approximately 2 inches in diameter. Another mistake people commonly make is allowing dirt to get onto the stump face during the application. Really try to avoid this. The dirt will deactivate the herbicide, especially if you are using glyphosate. Another mistake people make is drilling holes into the stump face. This is another technique that is suggested on some herbicide labels. The problem with this technique is that it does not target the herbicide to where that herbicide needs to be, namely the live inner bark of the tree. The inside portion of the tree is not living. Therefore, any herbicide applied there will be wasted. That's it. We would greatly appreciate it if you would like this video. Also consider being a subscriber to our channel. Most importantly, get out and enjoy a natural area near you that has lots of native species.